Hi, I'm Gerry from Gerry's Craft Room, and in this video I'm going to show you a bunch of heat and dry embossing techniques. And it's a video I made last year for a blog hop that fell through, but there are so many fun techniques in it that I had to share, so I did the voiceover again. I have a tag that I embossed with a stencil. The fab stencils are a bit thicker than most stencils and are great for embossing. I am applying ink with an ink blending tool, adding bits of color here and there. I have a video where I show you how you can dry emboss with a stencil, and I will link to that video at the top. I added most products I used in the description box for you, not all as some are discontinued. You can find a list of supplies also on my blog. And if you're new here and you like what you see, don't forget to subscribe. Now on this tag I'm going to add lots of layers, but you can use the techniques I show on separate projects too. I go over the embossed part lightly with the dark blue to make it stand out a bit more. And now I make splats with water and a fan brush to create some fun lighter spots. I made some color circles with the Wow embossing powders to put on top. This way the pretty colors are easy to see in my storage box and you can see the real colors you get when they are heat set. I make some more splats with the fan brush and water, and then I'm going to sprinkle on embossing powder and heat set it right away. The water will hold the powder until it's dry, so you have to have the heat tool nearby. I'm also going to color some metal keys with the embossing powder so they match the color scheme. And I melt the embossing powder off camera. And I have some die cuts from the Fab Scraps card pack that I embossed too. The embossing powder is a bit translucent, so you will still see the pattern of the paper. And I'm going to add another layer on the key to mix the color up a bit. And while you're here, have you seen the community tab at the top? Available on smartphone and desktop computer, I will share new and fun things there, like behind the scenes, sneak peeks, polls and such, so you can check that out if you like. And this is what the leaves look like after melting the embossing powder. I cut the beerboard bird apart from the frame and I inked the edge. I also added ink to the word and I'm going to emboss the word in two parts. I sprinkle on bits of embossing powder and then I shake it off. Then I add a second color, and then I'm going to melt it with the heat tool. Some more embossing on the flowers I cut out of the patterned paper. And here are the flowers I embossed, and then I shaped the leaves around the end of a paintbrush. Now I have all my parts and I'm going to glue them to the tag. I use glossy accents to add to metal parts. Besides that, you can use it for making fun embellishments. This also works great as a glue. I cut up the frame and I'm going to add that in two parts. Adding some splats with white gesso diluted with water. And I let that dry. I have a bit of white thread and I'm going to add some pearls and rhinestones. So here's the finished tag. Make sure to check back for part 2 next week. I hope you liked the video. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe. And make sure to keep on crafting!